For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to TechArkIT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that how you secure your web server using SSL certificate.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
Okay, so how you can add your SSL certificate to your web server and how this SSL certificate can secure your website. Okay, so the SSL certificate will secure your website based on this public key and private key. And the public key and private key is a pair of keys. When you have the public key, and it will ask you for the private key, so that data will be encrypted from the one end and decrypted on the other end. So the data, whenever it is transferring over the network, what happens is that it has some junk characters to that data, and whoever get the data, so they cannot able to see anything. So this something like junk characters. Then what happens is that whenever it reaches to the end, to the client, then it decrypts based on this SSL certificate. Okay, so it's a key pair of that SSL certificate will be data will be transferred over the secure server or the secure internet connectivity, so that the data cannot be sensitive data cannot be handed over to the somebody else who is a bad guy. Let's install a httpd package. So m install http star. Now package is getting installed. Now you have to say yes, then the packages will be installed. Most of the times, you know, no need to put http star, you can just put httpd star, so that the packages installation would be very less, or minimal packages you have to install. Now the packages got completed. Now install mod underscore SSL package, which is required to generate the SSL certificate. Say yes. Now got completed. Start enable the service and start httpd service. Verify this status and add this firewall rule to allow HTTP and HTTPS. By default, the service is HTTP and HTTPS. Reload this firewall settings to affect this settings. Now set enforce 0, in the sense disable the SELinux. Now go to default path slash for wwhtml, create a index.html file which requires for our just a test web page, like html tag just add and header 1. I'm just adding h1 over here and add something like testing website SSL TechArkIT, and close this h1 and close this HTML tag, save this file. Now go and in browser, just browse for website with the default website. Okay, now you can get it that the website is working fine. Okay, now you can able to see that without SSL, the website is working fine. Just go to this httpd configuration file, default configuration path, and here just copy this SSL certificate to somewhere else to secure this configuration file. Now generate the CSR file and provide this pacifier password, and country is in, and full name of the state you can provide, any whatever the state name, and city name you have to provide over here, and organization name, what is the organization name you have to provide over here, and add this section, in the sense what is your business unit and all the stuff you can details, and common name, so how it, you will call it as a common name for your host name or the common name you can simply provide, and saying the optional password and the company name. Okay, now CSR and PEM files are generated. Now generate using this PEM file key file. Now key file is been generated, and using that key file we generate the cert file for 365 days. Now if the files has been generated over here, CSR file, key file and PEM file, and now make some directories under /etc/pki/tls and some private and certs directory for copying these certificates and securing them, because nobody can download these certificates. We can restrict this permission chmod 6002, to restrict them, nobody can read or write any certificate. Okay, copy those certificates in, cert to CRT, and key file can be copied to the key file to the private path. Now file, this it enter, the file will be copied, server.key file. Done. Now go and edit this SSL configuration file. Okay, go to /etc/httpd/conf.d. Here I am SSL.conf. Here you have to do some changes. Actually, this is what we have to change over here. Now search for VirtualHost and change this default to star. Okay, this is the default to star, you just change it, and now you can look for server name and document root. You have to change this. Actually, this is the path you have to change. Sorry, it's X, not X. Actually, we are in insert mode, that's why it X. So just remove this hash value and change the server name to your server name. Actually, server name to your actual server name. Take ArkIT-Server.local. Now go and verify that CipherSuite is enabled and SSL protocol is enabled, and CipherSuite is enabled, and HonorCipherOrder is on, and SSL cert file, just replace that to the exact path where it is located actually. Okay, /etc/pkl/tls, and the path is going to be our certificate.csr file, cert.crt file. Okay, replace exactly the path. Now change the key file. So here is the cert key file, so this key file also you have to change it. Now whatever the key file we generated, the key file would be placed over here. That's it. Actually, these are the two files would be enough. CSR is not required, .pem is not required. Based on .pem file only we generated the cert and key files. Okay, that's it. Now it's the configuration is done, but we have to add this server admin and server who is going to be receive this server admin alerts. Okay, and verify whether we have SSL protocol enabled or not. Okay, CipherSuite is on or not, all these settings just verify it over here. Okay, CipherOrder is on, and now go ahead and see this whether our server admin email address is specified over or not. Okay, just go ahead and there is no server admin actually. Now you can simply go ahead on the virtual host level and add the server admin entry. Okay, here this virtual entry over here. Okay, you can simply go ahead and edit this configuration and paste it, server admin, and specify the email address who will receive this server admin alerts. Okay, now restart this HTTPD services. Wait, and okay, successfully restarted, and verify the configuration. So it says something like the server name is not fully qualified domain name, and now edit slash etc slash host file and add the entry over here, because we did not have any DNS on our local system. That's why we are adding the manual record over here. The slash etc host will resolve our host name so that it does not give that error. ARKIT hyphen server dot local. Save it. Now restart again, verify the configuration path, and now type HTTPS and browser. It will ask you to confirm the security and click on advanced and add an exception. Click exception. Now that's it. Your SSL certificate is installed successfully. This is what you have to do to install and configure your local certificate. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.